Who knew to get it?
Sure. So the question you've been reiterating in your columns is that there is now the time for so-called big bang reforms. You call demonetization as one in that category. But if I talk about the real fundamental issues that this country faces, one is about the judicial system. The other might be about the institutions which are in place, especially say the policing out there. So my question is that, fine, we've got the 1991 form, but for my generation, when will we get that 1991 moment back?
No, okay. Demonetization, I would not call a big bang reform.
Okay.
Because it by itself, it will achieve very little until we have a huge amount of follow-up.
Supplementary.
Sure. Yeah, because by itself, it barely touches the tip of the iceberg as far as black money is concerned. But I couldn't agree more with you that the biggest reforms we require today are police judicial reforms, are civil service reforms, institutional reforms. So we have a situation where if the courts are unable to find anybody guilty of anything, if you're a reasonably resourceful man, I mean, if you're a starving, illiterate man, they'll put you in jail and not.
I'll give you an example. I had a chance to go to the court. I ensured that it was an out-of-court settlement because I could not afford the court fee and the time for sure.
Yes. So, we have a system where, therefore, there is a huge advantage for every lawbreaker, and everybody who obeys the law looks an idiot.
Absolutely.
Now, this particular problem is infiltrating like a cancer into every section of society, be it politics, be it business, be it journalism, be it anything.
But does it start from the political authority? Because that's where the main executive power lies.
It starts exactly from there.
Right.
And the criminalization of politics, it's about erosion of institutions.
Right.
Why are there so many criminals? Mm-hmm. Because they are very useful. If you have money and you have muscles, and if you can't be put in jail, then instead of being a liability to the party, you
become
an
asset
to
the
party. So we need to crack this particular thing. And I am not sure how we do it, but there has to be some people who get sufficiently angry.
Because why I say that, because 1991 was more of an executive action, but in most of these cases, you need a lot of institutions to come together, and there are a lot of lobbies which will resist the change. So again, my question is that there are a billion youth aspirations out this in this country. When will our 1991 moment come? How do you see, foresee that?
You guys
coming?
Have already got it. But for 1991, you wouldn't be where you are.
Yeah.
So you are not the one who
the
was
new 1991 moment.
Having lived from 1942, having lived through the 50s and 60s and 70s, you guys are damn lucky.
No, but Mr. Ian, is because if you want India to be a superpower, in the time you do not do these institutional changes, how will you realize the aspiration of the young
person? So we need all these, but for all those, you require an explosive anger on the part of voters. The Aam Aadmi Party was one example of it. In some ways, Modi himself, to bringing in cleaner government or good government, the question of bringing in a better quality of governance, this is very necessary, for which the people of India will have to get sufficiently angry that the political parties also take it seriously.
My last word, if the youth of India is watching you out there, what's the message that you want to give them?
The sky is the limit. Give it. Go there.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining on Janki. A pleasure to have you on the show. Sir, thank you so much. Sir, I'll put this into one.